They stroll back for two. Now, has he nicked that? And he reviews it straight away.
Keep going through. Just rocking around in the back. There's a clear gap between bat and ball. And nothing on hole three. I'll go back on field.
Well, bizarre. Every single Sri Lankan player, apart from the two sweepers who are too far away. Down the pitch. Man out there. Man out there and dropped. Put down. And he falls down as well after. Edged. Gap four.
Well, there is movement, and England have been a bit skittish and sketchy this morning. Brooks should be out.
Down the pitch, what a shot that is, a whip. Hint of Peterson Flamingo about that shot from Pope. There's a bit of bottom hand in that from Ollie Pope. Another boundary to him. There's that gap again. Mind the gap, Sri Lanka.
Not this time, not this time. It's an excellent catch. Very sharp indeed by Comindo Mendes. And just as Ricky Ponting was predicting, Brooke uncomfortable. Oh, it goes through there again. In Nasser's gap. Well, the pressure continues to build. Oh, that's straight. Given. Chris Gaffney raises the finger. Pope is going to reluctantly send it upstairs.
Okay, original decision's out. Pitching outside.
Well, well, well. Oh, goodness me. Well, just rubbing salt into the wound. Bit more fortune. I think Smith actually played this reasonably well in the end. The ball moved late and just bounced on him a little.
Ooh, out. Clipped straight at mid-wicket. A ball onto the pads. Jamie Smith's eyes lit up. 150 for Ollie Pope.
Ollie Pope
had to battle hard yesterday. A couple of nasty blows onto the back elbow. And Sri Lanka at times have really challenged him today. But he's battled it out. And he scored his runs in good time. 150 from 151.
And really caring for your players. You see that in the England dressing room. And you see that at Surrey. 150 for Ollie Pope.
Gone again at extra cover. Chris Wokes can't believe he's just done that. He was trying to lift it up and over extra cover, smoke it away for four. That swing. Atkinson tries to go big leg side. He's picked out the fielder. Can he hold on? He can. Does well. England lose another.
Those are important chats to have.
Pulled into the deep, man there. Now Pope has gone and he cannot believe what he's just done. He's down on his haunches. The man hardly had to move.
No
one on the sweep on the boundary, so Ollie Stone has his first boundary. And he's pulled it straight to the man at square leg. So Josh Hull on debut, goes for two, and the plan has worked perfectly for Sri Lanka. Now, where's that gone? Straight over the keeper. There is a man as fly slip, but it's gone over him as well.
reckon that's gone all the way. Now, mid-off, should be taken, yes. Bashir's gone, England have gone, they've been bowled out here. It has been an excellent morning for Sri Lanka. Be pleased with what he's seen today.
Yeah, good fight back from Sri Lanka. As per there from this anchor, short and wide, and there are so many open spaces there now with all these close catches around. You put bat to ball.
Top class level of Test cricket. That's really well played. Enough gaps, no fine leg, and that'll run away to the boundary.
Good line, challenging line, and it just squared Nisanka up on the back foot. Good looking shot that from Nisanka. Okay, 19 for none. It was going to be a tight single for a minute, but even as the throw was coming in, it looked to me that the batters had... Good shot. Really solid thump down the ground from Karuna Ratna, who got a stride into the ball and played that with a lot of conviction. Atkinson having to give chase himself here. He's finally given way to Dan Lawrence. Well, the runs are rattling on here for Sri Lanka. Tight, surely, must be gone. That is a terrible run. It's a brilliant bit of cricket from Ollie Stone in the field, but that is a shocking run. And England have their first.
That was an awful, awful miscommunication. A very bad call. That Patum Nisanka's call hits it into the gap. Karuna Ratna not anywhere close, not taking a start, but even if he did, he would have still been short. Running in off two steps, bowling seam.
Well, I think his off spin is in need of some improvement. England generally have done without a fine leg at the start of the innings against Sri Lanka. Fuller clipped through the leg side. That will race across the square for four. Brings the 50 up.
It's a good pitch, this.
Punch through the offside. Off the back foot. Ollie Stone can't catch that. It's too wide there. An uppercut over the slips for a one bounce four. It's a poor ball from Chris Wokes. Gets what it deserves from Kusil Mendes. Full missing leg stump. Head. And caught. Harry Brook at second slip. Chris Wokes makes the breakthrough. Shot. Good shot down the ground. Time down the ground. Lovely way to bring up his 50. Short and wide. And gets the treatment. Nisanka's been sharp. Edged and caught. Fuller delivery from Ollie Stone. Into the attack and makes an immediate impact.
Cut firmly. There wasn't a lot of width, but with the angle of the left armour, there was enough. That's a very fine shot from Nisanka.
Oh, he's got it! What a catch! What a moment for Hull!
First Test match wicket. What a feeling he'll be having right now.
Pitched it up. Chris Wokes diving. Oh, brilliant catch. Caught Wokes, bold hull, your first Test wicket.
Oh, was there an inside edge? No, says umpire Gaffney, reviews straight away. From Ollie Stone, little bit of movement back in, and that is right in front. Definitely two noises, but he reviewed extremely quickly.
The original decision's out. Impact in line. Hitting the wickets. Go back to Chris on field. You see.
Well, there was definitely two noises. Maybe Chandamal hit his pad with his bat. We'll go back to the replays to have a look at that. Well, that's gorgeous. It'll bring the 100 up for Sri Lanka in some style. It's as simple as it gets from Kamindu. Equally as good, a little bit more width, and it goes to the right-hand side of Hull for another boundary. And again, three boundaries in the over, all high quality from Kamindu. 109 for 5, Mark Butcher. Shot. Ollie Stone looking to go full and attack the pads, and Dan Angeo was right up to it.
Short ball, but not a particularly potent short ball, and Janander De Silva looked as though he had all the time in the world putting that away to the leg side. Oh, there is a gap there. Not much of one, but there is between the third slip. Gets it away square this time with a bit more conviction. And that boundary should take us to the tea break.
Too many coffees. Bang down the ground. Beautifully played. Not afraid to use his feet and go over the top. Catch it. Oh, he's gone. He's fallen. I do not believe it. This time he connects. Just a little overpitched. Almost caught it on the fall, and it beats Gus Atkinson out there. Oh, that is a glorious shot. Just turned his body beautifully.
It's been placed and timed nicely. Chris Wokes gives chase. I think it's okay. We'll come back for three. They may have to check. Drop short. And he's just back cut that beautifully. That goes to the boundary, and Dan Angeo De Silva goes to 50. Oh, another just quicker slider, found the outside edge. Dan Angeo De Silva actually opened the face on it, but it probably went a bit finer than he thought. Now, he could get something on that, the back of the bat. Could have swept the previous delivery, let it go. This time he did sweep, and yes, given us runs. Clipped leg side, and there's no one out there. And another half century. Takes the aerial route leg side, and there's no one out there. Very good from Dan Angeo De Silva.
Nicely bowled.